And welcome to my Unreal Engine 4 tutorial series. And in this episode we're gonna make a widget switcher. So let me give you a quick look and what the widget switcher is. So if I hit a press play and if I open our widget, you can see this is our crafting and this is our skill, and both are in the same widget. So if you want to make this one, because in the most of the game you can find this widget switcher very oftenly. Because it is not the best way to do with all the key bindings like P for the map or E for the inventory. So it is not the best way to do that. So this is why we have made this widget switcher. So inside the single widget you can find many widgets, and you can just toggle it by pressing Q and E. I mean, whatever the key are key want to use, you can cycle it by this one. So you can add as many as you can and you can cycle it. So this is what we're gonna make today. So let's get started. Just close this up, minimize it. Inside here, this is my third person template. I'm gonna make a widget. So how are we gonna do that? Just make a folder and I'm gonna call it UI. Inside the UI, I'm gonna make a user interface and I'm gonna call it main widget. So main UI. And let's make a sub UI of it. So right click and I'm gonna call it a map. So this would be our map. Open this up. And I'm gonna just leave it blank and make some things so it looks more cool. So this is our border, and I'm gonna make the anchor point to cover the whole entire screen. Offset of the both things to 0, 0, so that's why it's acquire whole the screen. And there is a text inside this border, and the alignment of the text would be this, so it looks more, and I'm gonna call it a map. Let's change the color of this to something black, so, and the size of this font, so to 300 would be fine. I'm just gonna doing it this for showing purpose. So this is our map, duplicate that, and this is our inventory. So open that up, and this is our inventory. Yep, and duplicate that. And I want to, let's say what we want to add, I want to add skills. So this is our skills. Yep, I'm just doing it for showing purpose. So when you cycle it, it will gonna cycle from this three widgets. So how do you gonna do that? So open your main widget, and if you search in the palette the widget switcher, you're gonna find something like this, the widget switcher. So we have added a widget switcher, right? Just call it switcher because naming conventions are very important. And make the anchor point to cover whole the screen, so right offset and offset to 0. And inside the user created, if you open this up, you can see our all the user created. So I'm gonna add this widget switcher to first map, then inventory, and then the skills. And this will gonna toggle between these three. So you can see this, if you click on this switcher, you can see this active widget switcher index. So if you toggle between, you can see it is toggling between this one. The 0th index is this, the 1th index is this, and 2nd is this, so 0, 1, 2 and so on. You can add whatever you want, how much you want, it's don't actually matter. So we're gonna switch between these three. So how are you gonna do that? So go back to your graph, and in here you want to switch it. So how do you, first let's make a variable called index. So this will gonna set our index to whatever you want, and we're gonna make a function to switch the widget, and we're gonna call it by Q and E. So on the functions, first let's override an event call on mouse, not mouse button, on key down, this one. So this will gonna check whatever the key we are pressed, and based on that key we're gonna switch the events and turn off and off the toggling UI. So get a key. If the key is equal to the key that we are using, then we're gonna branch. But let's say you have to do certain things in that particular thing. So branch for every single key, getting a key and then checking if it's true or not. It's not the best way to do that. So how do you gonna do that? So first add a return node and call it a handle. So if you don't do this handle, then it will gonna iterate to every single key inside your keyboard, and you might face the FPS drop or lag, and we don't want that. So that's why we have added this one. So how do you wanna do that? So just delete this and first compile it, and we're gonna create a custom event. So custom event, and we're gonna call it key events. Yep. And inside this event, we're gonna add an input called key name, and this would be a string. So you can see our key string, and grab a node from this and call it on a switch on string. So based on this key name, we're gonna call the event. So let's add an array element. So click on this string and you can see an array element. So the first key would be Q, the second key would be E, and the third key would be tab. Let me show you quickly. So if you hit Q, then it will gonna go to previous page. If you hit E, then it will gonna go to next page. And if we hit tab, then it will gonna close the widget. So turning on and off. And we're gonna add this widget inside here. So inside here, get display name. So get key display name, something like this. And we're gonna call that key events we have just created. So key events. We have just made this function, right? So we're gonna just call this function. So just click on this, and if you attach it to here, it will convert the text into a string, and we need that. To hit compile and save and go back to your event graph. So this is more much than checking every single thing from branch. So this is more much more efficient. And right now we're gonna make a function to toggle this. How are we gonna do that? So make a function and we're gonna call it next page, and we want to add an input called is next page. So is previous page, and we're gonna call it to a boolean. The type of this is previous page is boolean. So if we press Q, then we're gonna call the next page function. And because we are pressing Q, then it will gonna go to left one. So left one is a previous page. So you're gonna call this one to true. Yep. And if it's not, then we're gonna just call this one to not true. So next page. And this is not true because we want to go to next page and not right side. Yep. And if we hit tab, then what we want to do, we want to remove this widget. So remove from parent. After removing from parent, we want to set the input mode of this to game only, not this widget. So set input mode to game only, and the player controller would be get player controller, obviously. So we have done the part. Let's check it out first. And many people do this beginner mistake. I have seen this. So click on this main UI and you can see this is focusable. Make sure it is true, because otherwise the interaction won't happen inside your widget. Many beginners make this mistake. The is focusable is not true, and then they can't interact inside the widget. Another mistakes they do is they can interact with the keyboard, but they cannot interact with mouse. So because you have implemented two widgets, let's say one is your HUD and second one is this one, and your HUD's Z order is higher than your the widget of the second one, so your mouse cannot detect this one because the layer of the HUD widget is upper part. So make sure the Z order of the interaction widget is upper, otherwise the mouse interaction won't work. The widget switcher would work fine. So let's test this out. So minimize it, and we want to call it inside our third person. So I'm just gonna open the third person and right click and hit a tab. So whenever I press tab, I want to create a widget. Widget would be our obviously which one, the main UI, and I'm just gonna add this to viewport, to add to viewport. After adding towards the viewport, I wanna set the widget input mode. So set input mode to UI only. So set input mode to UI only. Widget to focus is obviously the return value of this main UI. Set mouse one to do not lock. Get your player controller from this. So get player controller and set show mouse cursor to true. So obviously we want to show our mouse control, or we don't want to do the mouse interaction, so it's fine. Show mouse cursor. Yep. Hit compile and save, and you can see we have added the map inside our matlab. We have added the three widgets, and this all three widgets gonna do the interaction part. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna add another widget because we don't want to lose the focus in our main widget. So right click and you can search for on focus lost. So on focus lost, what we're gonna do, we're gonna simply set focus. So set user focus to self. So it's this focus and the get player controller. So this is important thing because we don't want to lose the focus. So just hit compile and save. Inside it here, we have done this part, right? Let's test this out if it's working or not. Hit play, hit tab again. You can see we can toggle it, and this will gonna print the first index of the map. So it is working. So let's on the close this player character because we don't need that on the main UI. Let's score this next page. So how are you gonna do that? So let's add a branch, and if our next page is true, then we're gonna follow the false part, and if its previous page is false, I mean the this one, then we're gonna follow this one, otherwise this one. So how are you gonna do that? So get your index first, and I want to decrement the index if you want to follow the previous part. So I want to decrement the index. After that, get the index and less than or equal to. No, only less than, because the index is already set to zero on this one. So if our index is less than zero, then we want to do the thing. So if our index is zero, then we want to set it to the maximum index of our widget have. So how do you wanna do that? So inside here you can see this switcher, get this switcher and get children's. So you want to set get all the children's. So you can see this will return an array because we wanna get this children, and you can see right now we have three children, so it will gonna get all the children's. And we want to set the last index. So what is the last index? So just count it, and the last index with set to your index. So set index, and this would be your last index. So obviously if we have inside the map, and if you had the previous button, so if you press it will go back to your scales, the last index of this one. So we have done the previous part. It was very simple, right? On the next part, we want to do the opposite thing. So we have to increment the integer, attach it to true part, and inside we want to check if it's greater than or equal to. And what is the greater than or equal to? So we want to set it. So get the switcher, and what we want to do, so we want to get the index. So get index, so get the widget, active widget index, yep, and attach it to true. If it's true, then we want to follow this part, branch, and after that set the index. to 0. Pardon? So not the active widget. I think we want to set the last index. So it's currently active index is greater than, if our active index is currently greater than or equal to the last index, then we want to set this. So let's test it out. I might think we have done a mistake, but so if I tab, if I press Q, nothing is happening. So let's see where we messed up. So yep, we want to set it here. So add a sequence. So first we follow this part, and after this part we actually want to set the index. So get the switcher and get set the active widget index. So how are you gonna set that? So inside here, we want to get the index. So set the active widget index, this one, set this one in your one part. So after doing that, we actually want to set the index, and the index would be your this one. Attach it to here, hit compile, save, and let's test this out. So if we tab, if we hit Q, if this is working, but the next part is not working, right? Because so how are you gonna do that? Okay, so inside the switcher, get last. Okay, this one. So what we want to do, we want to set this switcher's last, set get child index, not this one. I think this is the one, because we want to set it to our child class count, right? And let's test this out. Yep, we can toggle it with both way. So if I press E, then it will toggle it to something like this. If I press Q, then it will toggle it, and you can toggle it on and off. And right now I am on the scale part, and if I toggle back and if I toggle again, it will open with map. If you want to save it to this part, this will simply, what you want to do, you can just simply set this index. So on your event create, this one, on your event construct, you want to just set that index to the saved index. And actually you want to and you have to set this index to something that is not static. So this main UI, you can simply save it, but if you remove it from parent, it will construct it back to the default values. But you want to do that, so you want to set this index to your player character or like game mode or controller or whatever you want, or the HUD blueprint of the current HUD, it's best way to do that. So it's up to you. So this is all for now. So thank you so much guys for watching, and bye bye.